everyone, myself Usha Patil. I am a counselor. Today we are learning a new skill, that is a speaking skill. Speaking skill is a very useful and it is very important skill as a student everyone has to learn. Speaking skill are the skill that give us the ability to communicate effectively. Speaking skill help us to improve our language. Whenever we communicate, we use two types of language. In that, the first one, the verbal language. In the verbal language, we communicate with the words. Second, non-verbal language. In non-verbal language, we communicate without words, like we communicate through our body language, gestures, facial expression, tone of our voice, and eye contact. Whenever we are communicating with anyone, if we use verbal and non-verbal language together, always our communication will be more effective. For effective speaking skill, we have to follow some simple steps. Then the first one, choose the topic. So whenever we are preparing for our speech, that time we have to choose one topic which one I am more comfortable. And second one, make notes on that selected topic. For example, 3-4 topics are given in that. I selected one topic which one I feel more comfortable to express it. That topic, I have to write notes on that. And the third, visualize. So whatever topic we have selected, we have to visualize about that topic. In that, if I am selected a topic like nature, so in the visualization, I have to visualize how nature will look. According to that, I have to make notes on that. And the fourth one, understand it in first language. So whatever topic I am selected, the first I have to understand in my mother tongue, that is first language. It may be in Kannada, Marathi or Hindi, whatever it may be. And fifth one, express it in second language. When I understand the topic in my first language, that is very easy for me to express it in second language. Sixth one, practice it again and again. So after making notes and when we prepare about the topic, so we have to practice it again and again. Seventh, if possible, make a video recording or audio recording and see it for yourself, or show it to your parents or a teacher. And eighth one, be relaxed while presenting your speech. So whenever we are presenting our speech, we have to be relaxed. So what will happen, most of the children, they prepare their notes, they are very well prepared about the presentation and all, but while presentation they get anxious. So because of anxiety, some kids are not able to express it whatever they prepared in their mind. So being relaxed is very important before our speech. Ninth, complete with conclusion part. So whenever we are concluding our speech, we have to conclude with conclusion part. So what all we want to convey through that speech, that we have to cover it in conclusion part. Dear kids, it is very easy task and it is very interesting task also. Once we start practice it again and again, definitely I tell you, our communication skills will improve. And it is very helpful for us to express our thoughts and emotion in front of anyone. Good luck, children. Thank you.